Hello and good morning to all. Welcome to your computer class. It is the third part of our second chapter, that is Internet Services and Multimedia Technologies. Till now in this chapter we have discussed about the information retrieval system and we have also discussed about the emails. Well, in this part we have to discuss about the search engines and the working of search engine. First we have to discuss that what is search engine. Well, we have already discussed about this term in the previous session. But we will start from this term only. So we have to discuss that what is search engine. Well, generally you all might have found that whenever we have a question in our mind or whenever we have to find something or whenever we have a doubt or a query, we all have this habit to search that thing on Google. Fine. And when we Google something, we get n number of results over there. And almost in every result, we have some solutions of our query. Fine. So this search engine is a program that searches through a database of web pages for particular information. It means whatever keyword you will write in that text box or in that search box will be searched by these search engines in the entire internet. Fine. And the result that you will get, that result will be a summary result of the database that it will retrieve from the internet. You all might have found that whenever we search anything, we get various links, where each link is a individual web page which contains some results regarding our search queries. Fine. Now some most commonly used search engines are Google, Bing and Yahoo. Now you must be thinking that why we have listed only these three. The basic reason is that it has been found that in a monthly basis, Google is one of the most popularly used search engine. Then in the second and third position we have Bing and Yahoo search. Now let's discuss about that how we can find something on search engine or how we have to use these search engines. Well, for finding information on search engine, let's take an example. We are using Google here. Fine. Suppose you want to search something. So first, before searching anything, we have to visit to the home page of that search engine website. Fine. Over here in this picture, this page that you are able to see, it is our Google's search home page. Fine. Well, in this home page, we have to type the information in the search box. Fine. It means whatever query you have or whatever information you want to search, you have to type that query over here in this search box. And after doing this much, you have to click on this search button. Fine. You have to click on this search button to find the queries or some links which will show you your result. Fine. So, when you will click on the search button, your search engine will now display you some results. Fine. So, here it's a Google's result page. As you can see, in this page we have multiple results. Fine. In this result page we have various links. Fine. Each link is a link of an individual web page which may carry your searched data. Fine. Now, from these links you can easily find your search information. Now, the most important thing that we have to discuss in this topic is that how this search is being used by the Google. Fine. Well, this Google search process or any search engine search process is very important. Fine, and it is very complicated also, so we have to go through it once very properly. Fine, so now let's begin. So now our basic objective is to learn that how search engines generally work. Fine, this question is generally asked in your exams. They will ask the components of a Google search. Fine, they can even ask the components of a simple search engine. Fine, they can even ask that how a search engine works. And there can be a long question about the working of a search engine. For all these questions, your answer will be the similar one. Fine. Now let's begin. Generally, whenever we have to search something, we type a keyword in the search engine and then search engine performs that search operation. Fine. So it is that thing that we are able to see. But in the back end, there are so many processes or there are so many applications which are running. Fine. So a search engine works with the help of following three elements. The first element is spiders or crawlers or bots or agents. Then our second element is indexing software and database. And our third element is search algorithm. Fine. Only these three components helps us to search something from web. Fine. So we have to discuss about all these three components in detail now. We have to know that how these components works and what are their importance. Now let's begin with the first one. The first component is spiders or web crawlers, which are also known as crawlers, or bots or agents. generally these spiders or these bots or these agents are some special type of programs. Fine, these are some crawling programs which will crawl from page to page. Fine. So search engine uses a software or it is a script which is termed as a spider or a crawler, which comb the internet looking for documents and their web addresses. Fine. So it simply means that whenever we upload something new in our website or in our blogs or in our YouTube channels, fine, that content is being searched by these spiders or these web crawlers. Fine. And when these spiders or these web crawlers find all these content, they simply highlight some important word of that content and then they create a log list of everything. Fine. The spiders or web crawlers perform the methodical searches needed to find the information. It means whenever you will upload something on internet, these crawlers or these spiders will first search your page and they will find out everything what you have written over there. Fine. Then this information is given directly by the search engine and then they crawl from one server to another. Fine. So it means after searching in one page, they will simply move to the other page or some other server, and then again and again they have to repeat this task. Fine. While they are doing this task, they will compile a huge list of URLs. It means they will search for multiple websites and they will scroll from one page to another. Fine. So what they are simply doing, they are simply finding for queries or some keywords that we are writing in our web pages. Fine. Next we have indexing software and database. Fine. So now after the web crawlers have found some keywords in our web pages, it is very important for our search to store that, or it is very important for our search engine to store that log list or that keyword list into a database. So for that, an indexing software is used. Now this indexing software is a list of documents or web addresses collected by the bots are sent to the indexing softwares. The indexing software extracts information from the document and web addresses, prepares an index of it and stores in a database. Fine. Now in general, whenever we search something, that content has some keywords. Fine. Like for example, you want to search about a particular sports player. Suppose you want to search about MS Dhoni. So you will simply write a term in the search engine that will be MS Dhoni. Fine. Now this indexing software will fetch that term that we want to search and then it will look for that term in the database. Fine. So it means this indexing software is generally helping a user to identify something or to locate something from the search engine's database. And one most important thing is there. Well, whenever we search something on a repetitive nature, then in that case, it is the priority of our indexing software to put that thing in the top list. Fine. Now let's suppose that you are opening a website for multiple times in a day. So now it means that that website is a main content source for yourself. So in that case, your search engine will first show you that website and then the other results. And this is how these searches are managed. Next, we have search algorithm. Now, for performing this all task, it means for fetching all these keywords and giving the data to the user and then searching the things on the database, searching the thing on the web, there is a particular structure or a program that is being followed. And that program or structure is termed as our search algorithm. In this search algorithm, every web browser, every search engine, every website has some different set of rules which are being followed. Fine. And in these set of rules, they have a proper method for searching or identifying data from the search engines. So now when you perform a search by entering keywords, the search engine software searches its database using a particular search method, and that method is termed as search algorithm. And then it displays the matching document on web address. Fine. It looks like to be a very simple process, but it's a very time taking and it's a very lengthy process. Now we have to discuss about all these three components with the help of some pictures. Now look over here. Whenever we upload something on net or on internet, these spiders or these crawlers are the programs which start reading our content. So it means these spiders and crawlers will simply read our pages and then they will link all the pages in which they have a similar keyword. Fine. Well, there's a possibility that on one day there will be thousands of pages which can be uploaded, and in these pages, in all these pages, there can be a similar or there can be a common content. So these spiders and crawlers generally find out all this content and then they will comb them with their webs. Fine. After that, this information is given to the search engines, and then our search engines combine these results and these findings in a index. Fine. It means then our search engine stores everything in a database, fine, in a collective manner. And then when we perform any search operation, we get our result on the basis of these web crawlers and these databases which are being stored. Fine. So it means everything on internet is depends on this search engine only that we are able to see, and it depends totally on the web crawlers and the databases. Fine. Now let's understand this very properly. Well, suppose you are uploading a page on the internet. First, that page will be read by the crawlers, and then that thing will be stored in the computer's database. Fine. All these URLs and everything will be stored in the database. And then when a user will perform any search, then that data will be given to the user by using these indexing softwares only. Fine. So this is all for today. It was a very short video only about the search engines. But if still you have any doubt, in that case you can comment down all your doubts and queries, and I will give you a proper reply over there only. Fine. Now in our next class, we have to discuss about these few protocols and these few terms which are related to the web services. Fine. These few terms are Telnet, SSH, SCP and SFTP. Fine. So this is all for today. Thanks for watching. Stay healthy and stay safe.